Originally, I planned to do a completely different Nepal trek to this, rebooking the trek that I'd previously booked in 2020 that was cancelled due to the pandemic. A few weeks before departure, the tour company told me that they were cancelling the trip again because I was the only person booked on it. I could either change to a different trek or they would return my deposit. I felt utterly devastated. I've been straining at the bit to get back to the Himalayas through the whole pandemic, looking forward to this booking for most of 2022, so there was no way I wasn't going trekking somewhere in Nepal.
We have descended at Jibuvan International Airport, and the local time is 7:15 in the evening.
The first half of this alternative trip is the Annapurna Circuit, which I had done before in 2002. This is a brilliant trek with amazing scenery, and I thought it would be interesting to see how things had changed after 20 years. The second half is to the Annapurna Sanctuary. This was new to me and had been on my bucket list for years. This choice also allowed me to keep my original flights. It finished on the same day as my original choice. I had one extra day in Kathmandu at the start, which I spent looking around the shops. We had a phone call. We'd taken all our bags, plus one more.
That's Kathmandu before.
It's incredible.
It's been chopped in, doesn't it? It's just chopped.
Yeah. New mountain. In 2002, our brakes failed, 90 minutes out from Kathmandu. Fortunately, we were in slow traffic in town and not on a mountain track with a steep drop. We just drove into the bus in front. We waited while a replacement bus was sent from Kathmandu. 30 minutes later, bus 2 was flagged down,
because there was smoke coming out from underneath it. One of the wheel bearings had gone. Someone walked ahead to find help. This small truck, borrowed from a local, took 15 trekkers and our group leader to a roadside inn where we could get food. It returned for our luggage and the other 13 crew. After lunch, we continued to the nearest town. The truck owner needed his truck back, so 29 people plus luggage all went together. In the town, we hired a third bus. We got to the checkpoint for entering the Annapurna National Park just 30 minutes before it closed for the day. Otherwise, we would have had to turn back. In 2002, we stayed overnight in Bessie Saha, and then it took 2 days to walk what we drove this time in 2 hours. I'll only show photos from the old trip where there's something different to see. Here's what we saw on foot. We also had an overnight stop in Bahundanda. In 2018, for the trek to Mustang, we took a bridge and tunnel to drive up the other side of the river. We passed the Sino hydroelectric plant before crossing the river again. Then the 34 kilometres from Bessie Saha to Jagat took us 3 hours. This year it took 2.25. We left the road for a nicer footpath on the other side of the river. We were told this village, Tal, had been mostly washed away in heavy monsoon floods the year before.
Master.
We doubled back down the valley to cross the river at the bridge.
District, you know, chats work with colours.
In 2012, I saw this road being hammered out the side of the mountain with pneumatic drills. This was at the end of the Manaslu circuit, which joins the Annapurna circuit at Dharapani to descend the valley to Besisahar. Previous treks we used this alternative route up the other side of the river, shown here from my trek to Mustang in 2018. We also took this route for my 2002 Annapurna circuit and descending from the Manaslu circuit in 2012. Now that bridge is gone, washed away by the same floods that took parts of Tal village.
Oh,
Manaslu Circuit emerges here from the valley opposite to descend to Besi Sahar.
Following the road, are we? We go round the...
That's right, yeah. Just carrying the walk.
Yeah, we should do sort of like a Facebook live kind of thing.
Ready?
The trail to Mustang via Nar turns off here. Most of the tea houses had Wi-Fi and battery charging, occasionally for an extra fee. Last time I was here, there was a suspension bridge.
Maybe two.
Maybe.
Fireplace, no fire.
Delicious fast food. Is that delicious or fast food?
Twenty years ago, they were still building this temple.
Puri Green Lake Tar.
Green Tar.
Green Tar.
Like a long time ago.
Just keep walking, Stephen.
Yeah, I go.
He was complaining before, we all stopped behind him and the players shot his settle.
Yeah.
open day. If we went higher too quickly, altitude sickness was a possibility. We stayed 2 nights in Manang to allow time for acclimatisation. In the morning, we all climbed up to Praken Gompa.
Okay, we got it.
In 2002, we visited the current nun's father in the Gompa.
Thank you very much.
You want to bless the seat?
The nun gave each of us a blessing. In the afternoon, we were free to do as we wanted. I went to see the moraine below Annapurna by myself. I saw a path up the moraine, so I went up to see the view. Then I just kept going. Checking my map now, there was a tea house and a viewpoint at the top. In the evening, we checked our blood oxygen saturation with an oximeter which clips onto a finger. Mine was 94%.
I'm gonna face this way.
Maybe there's a snow leopard around here.
Could be, could be. And leftover bottle will come and eat.
Yeah, that's how it works. That's some dinner for the snow leopard.
Cycle of nature.
Check that out.
When they feel like a danger, they come close to the human.
So,
maybe there'll be a snow leopard somewhere down there.
It's
just,
it's cunning creatures, that could be anywhere.
Because they're running quite fast, you know, something happened.
होइन माथि नै अब भोलि भोलि यताउता गरौँ सजिलो हुन्छ नि
Because of the altitude, we only did a short walk in the morning to stay a few hundred metres higher.
Thank you.
In the afternoon, we walked higher and then back to help acclimatise. In the evening, my oxygen saturation was still at 92% to 93%. In 2002, we stopped one place sooner at Yatkarka, since there wasn't a high camp then to reach the next day. That trip, we were given a demonstration of the portable altitude chamber that they were carrying. This could be used to help someone with altitude sickness until they could be taken to a lower altitude.
I'm going to go to the next one.
Thank you.
I thought so many food going that way.
The dining room was absolutely packed with people, even standing in the spaces, trying to keep warm. Not ideal for just after the pandemic.
Okay, don't miss the viewpoint.
You want my days?
In the evening, my oxygen saturation was down to 88%. In 2002, we walked from Yak Kaka to Thorung Fedi in the snow. Our acclimatisation walk that time was up to the emergency helipad. At 4:30 a.m. we set off for the pass with head torches. The pass was 670 metres above base camp, then we had 1750 metres to descend to our tea house. In 2002, we had to climb 1,000 metres from Fedi. Those of us who wanted them were issued crampons that attached to our boots with stretchy rubber.
On the side, there are all queues over there.
Yeah, there was a big gap.
Big gap over there, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah,
Those who didn't put on crampons on the pass were struggling on the steeper slopes. I stopped and put them on now.
All pictures taken?
No, it's good, thank you.
They're continuing the road to go right over the pass. This Buddhist monastery was originally built in the 6th century and was renovated in 2018. This is a joint Hindu and Buddhist temple. Around it are 108 water chutes in which people were bathing for purification. This is a new Buddhist statue completed in 2016. People have visited here for over 3,000 years to see the small sacred flames from volcanic gas burning as it comes up through water. They are just visible through a grill under the altar.
with my back.
We had a bus transfer to Tatopani. Took a short walk while other passengers on our bus disembarked and unloaded their luggage. I asked for a photo stop.
That's good.
Washed away or something.
Something was wrong with our bus. People crawled underneath doing something to it. At least the driver was able to stop where there was a waterfall and refreshments. In 2002, we took 4 days to walk what took one morning on the bus this time. The Kaligandaki River Valley was very dusty. We used scarves as masks. The hot springs at Tatopani were in a different place next to the river.
Hello.
Thank you.
We got out the head torches again to leave the tea house at 5:10 a.m, arriving on Poon Hill at 6 before sunrise.
There's got to be a secret anywhere in this one, right? We returned for a 7:30 breakfast. Doing just the Annapurna Circuit in 2002, we descended from Gorapani to Birathanthi. The next day there was just a short walk to the roadhead at Lumley for our bus transfer to Pokhara. We had one stop at a good viewpoint, and another for the crew to crawl under the bus and bash its underside with rocks. The rest of the day we enjoyed the lake. Some of us took a rowboat trip to see a temple on an island. The rickshaw to the airport broke down too. The rest of this year's trek was all new to me. When people do just the Annapurna Sanctuary trek, they start at Nepal and trek 2 to 3 days to Gorapani before continuing as we did. To acclimatise to the altitude, they take 5 days to reach Annapurna Base Camp. Already acclimatised, we did it in 4 days.
This cap is a much cheaper version. It feels like an alloy.
feels really insubstantial.
Modern cat.
Yeah.
Well, like they used to
be. That
big steel thing he had. That, you know.
Weighed
a ton. Just saying. I don't even think he likes it. I don't know, he might like to carry it.
I'm guessing that's the closest airport.
Thank you.
You are from Tamron to do the square. Hell, you'll see it
after.
Namaste.
where I live, there are wild horses up on the hills.
Onwards.
Here and at base camp, we had to sleep three to a room rather than two elsewhere. Many trekkers here.
Are we going up that?
You'll be diamond in the A lot of the gems are under the rock, inside the rock.
Gems inside rock?
Yeah, like black rock like that. When you break down, there's gems.
Like
crystal or something. Blue gems.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Worth cracking one up?
Yes.
Base camp for a mountain that you're not permitted to climb. Apparently, while this is called Annapurna Base Camp, climbers usually climb from the opposite side, and probably in the spring and not November. After lunch, we did a short walk higher, hoping to enjoy the views.
Try to without oxygen also, you pass away.
Yeah, but that's not what...
We come tomorrow before we leave and do this as well.
Thank you.
We waited a while to see if the cloud cleared, but it didn't.
Go up further.
Yeah. Look, he's down there.
Absolutely lost track.
Must be three tomato.
Yeah.
from. The tea house was a nice modern built place, feeling very clean and comfortable, but it was only plumbed up with cold water. The one hot shower was in the toilet at the end of the garden. The Jinu Danda suspension bridge was completed in 2018 and has a span of 287 meters. To get across just how long that is, here is my entire crossing uncut. That was 287 metres. The longest suspended footbridge in Nepal is the 567 metre Gandaki Golden Footbridge, while the longest in the world is the 721 metre Sky Bridge in the Czech Republic. This bridge has a sag in the centre of 14.5 metres. It's 140 metres high.
It's again body under.
I suspect this jeep trail was the reason that there were fewer people walking the trail today.
That's a serious trick. I've got a Caribbean in his hand.
See them on tripping.
That's what you call serious.
Thank you.
It's okay to look. This is the soul ritual. Time to see him here. Yes, to reach it. Yeah, to reach it.
Yeah.
It's probably like the M1 where it was originally built.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching.